Moses Wukenya, Nelson Dasima, Sanyu Najuma, Sharif Kawoya, Augustine Batanda, Gilbert Nayebale, Safia Segawa and Teddy Semakula, all members of the Revolution Against Dictatorship and Torture Survivors Movement pressure groups who were arrested in March for protesting the misappropriation of iron sheets meant for the vulnerable Karamojong communities have been freshly charged with inciting violence.
Each of the accused persons will execute a cash bond of 200,000 shillings. The sureties will execute a non-cash bond of 2 million Uganda shillings. The accused persons shall, prior to their release, furnish this court with a copy of their respective national identity cards.
The group had been granted bail by Buganda Road Grade 1 Magistrate Asman Muhumuza. However, before they could leave court, they were again arraigned before Grade 1 Magistrate Sienna Owomugisha and freshly charged with inciting violence.
The DPP and the police have sufficient manpower resources to apprehend or arrest the accused persons if they have other charges against them.
They all denied the charge and were remanded to Luzira prisons until the 29th of May 2023.
And in the event we fail to get all of them, we shall come back to the same court to apply for revision of the terms of bail.
This caused one of them to faint. Initially, the group had been charged with assaulting Assistant Superintendent of Police Flavian Smenta.
Because we saw the state prosecutor trying to register a file when another matter is ongoing, all in the name of trying to stop court from granting them bail. These are offenses which were alleged to have been committed at the same time. It is shocking that the police and DPP preferred an offense of assault and forgot to charge them with incitement of violence on the same day.
On the 27th of March, the eight suspects carried iron sheets demanding that the government arrests the ministers implicated in the misappropriation of Karamoja iron sheets, arguing that it will bring justice to the vulnerable people of Karamoja sub-region who were the original intended beneficiaries of the said iron sheets.
The state objected to the bail application on several flimsy grounds, and one of them is the accused persons did not provide their national IDs and letters of recommendation from their LOCs.
Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.